And good evening now. Thanks for being with us here for News 19 at 7. We have our political insiders with us tonight, our Democratic strategist Antoine Seawright, our Republican strategist Dave Wilson, and we're here to talk about a lot of things that have been going on inside the State House over the last several days. But before we jump into actual legislation and things that are pending, let's talk about something that happened earlier this week that caught the attention of everybody in South Carolina, and that's that deadly prison riot at Lee Correctional. 7 inmates ended up dying that night. 22 others were injured. Today, the State Corrections Department says they're calling for an independent investigation into what happened there, although they say they feel confident that this was all about territory and cell phone use. And there's been some questions about whether or not the officers, the corrections officers who were on scene, acted quick enough. Let's just dive right in and talk about the situation with our state prisons. The state corrections director continues to maintain they're understaffed.
That has been an argument that Brian has been making time and time again, because there is a shortage. You can drive down the interstate and you see ads that are on the sides of trucks asking for people who are interested in becoming officers with the Department of Corrections. What's going on right now, though, is the income that they could make off of that is nothing in comparison to the amount of risk that they're having to take to be in these prisons, because understaffed prisons, as Antoine would say, are just as bad as understaffed and underfunded schools. And that's really what we're dealing with, is a fundamental funding issue, because you can't get the people in there that you need to be able to do the job.
My, how the world turns. We got a Republican talking about funding, increasing funding. Oh, how the world turns. No, on a serious note, first of all, to the officers who do serve, thank you for the service. Secondly, this was not something that caught just statewide news. This caught worldwide attention. The largest riot in our state's history, 7 people dead, 17 injured. I'm told that for every one officer, that person is responsible for 200 inmates. We have a crisis in our prison system. And the truth of the matter is, I blame sole blame at the foot of the General Assembly for not stepping up to the plate and giving the prison director, corrections director, what he needs to do his job effectively. We have the same issues on the highways with our troopers, DJJ, and a number of state agencies that have been underfunded. And as a result, these type things happen, and there's nothing we can do except call for investigations. But someone or something has to happen for leadership to say, wow, it's time to do something different. I wish the governor would have called for increase in funding for corrections in his state instead of talking about tax cuts. We talked about on this show, when you cut one thing, something will bleed. When you start cutting to the bones of state government, we see bleeding. And when bleeding happens, these type of things the capacity to happen.
What's going on right now is a lot of what we're seeing, we've seen it, everything. We talked about it with roads. We've talked about it with education. It is not until an emergency comes up that we actually are having action take place. And that has been that whole kind of lead from the moment of urgency instead of thinking long term, because we've got so many issues that we're having to focus on, and that it's just taking one right after the other, right after the other. And that makes it very difficult for us to do that kind of long range planning that needs to be done, like you would see happening with any other business.
This was the worst prison riot in the last 25 years in the U.S. when it comes to the number of lives lost, as far as the number of inmates who died on Sunday night. Here we are at budget time right now. We're crunch time with state lawmakers. Is there a way right now to finagle money into that budget to help the state corrections director hire more officers?
Show me your budget, I'll show you what you value. It's important to note that Dave Party controls the General Assembly. They control every statewide constitutional officer. If funding our prisons, funding roads, education, if any of those things were important, then the Republicans would have made it a priority in their budget over the past whatever years, because this problem didn't just bubble up overnight, my friend. This has been going on for a very long time, and you have to be honest about that part.
Well, and this is a part where I'm going to put it back on the Democrats to do their part as well in this, JR, and the fact that we have got to have a real look at the full breadth of issues that we as a state need to face. Republicans and Democrats have got to come together and say, what are our priorities? Because as Antoine has rightly said, where you spend your money demonstrates your priorities. And right now, we're just spending because we've got the next emergency, and governing from the point of emergency instead of governing from a plan means there are going to be a lot of things that fall through the cracks.
What's happening on the Republican side is they've gotten away from priorities and started focusing on an agenda. An agenda that that will make cute sound bites and talking points for the rhetoric instead of funding the core functions of state government. And that's the issue. And guess what? Prisons, like education and like everything else, they should not be a partisan issue. It should be a matter of doing the right thing and being a priority. Unfortunately, Dave, you all just haven't led on that. And it's okay to call your party out for not doing what they're supposed to do.
And so the other side of this is the fact that we've got to start looking at other places to bring funding into the state so that we can have the business and growth expansion that we need to be having so that we can have an expansion of dollars flowing into the budget.
Right, and as we talk of the budget, where are we on that process right now?
The budget has passed out of the Senate. For the most part, a bipartisan budget. There were a few votes against it. It will go back to the House. The House will likely non-concur, and so that means the budget will be fought out and debated in the conference committee. God knows what could happen between now and then, considering it is an election year. And then essentially that will come back to the General Assembly and eventually make its way to the governor's desk, in which the governor will decide what he will not, what he will and will not veto.
So that's part of the ongoing process that takes place, JR. And for folks back at home, this is a time where you have three senators and three representatives. They're going to be part of that conference committee. And those six members, along with all of the staff that go along and help to write the budget and put all the pieces together, they're going to be spending a lot of concentrated time going through line by line by line, figuring out, okay, if the House says this, the Senate says this, where are we going to compromise? So that when we get to the end of the day, unlike what happens at the federal level, we've got to balance the budget.
I want the boys and girls at home to know that on that six-person committee, there's only one person from the minority party, one Democrat from the House and one from the Senate. So whatever comes out, very likely it will not be the slim voice of the minority viewpoint.
But let's also be honest about who is most likely going to be those Democratic voices that are going to be on there are the same strong Democratic voices that are on there on a regular basis and we need to be dealing with.
We're going to leave that conversation there. We need to take a quick break, but when we come back, we're going to talk about that Dominion deal. Is it on the verge of collapsing? And one of Antoine's favorite subjects, President Trump. We'll be talking about Nikki Haley and Lindsey Graham. That's coming up in just a moment.